about bound angle pose. There are lots of variations, of course, like all the poses. So if we're going to do this seated, you would bring the bottoms of your feet together, and then you bring them as close to your sit bones as you can. I want to talk about this more as a reclined pose, partly because I think it's easier to understand versus using all of the core muscles to hold ourselves up. Often, if you are doing this in a restorative class, you might be reclining on a bolster. That is always an option. If you are doing restorative, you would also have a strap typically around the feet to help you sink into that relaxation state. So we're gonna come onto our back here and talk about what's happening. So we flex the knee, okay? So the knee is bent, so that's the hamstrings. That's gonna be contracting. The quad's gonna be eccentrically contracting, so it's lengthening. We're bringing the bottoms of the feet together. We can scooch the pelvis towards the heels. And there are different settings on your blocks. So I am typically pretty tight in this pose. So I bring the bottoms of my feet together. I like to have the block on the higher side setting here. You could also do it this way, which would bring the knees even closer together. You could bring it down, which brings them further away. I kind of like, this one is comfortable for me. Those are things you can play with, and you could even put a bolster underneath, or you can put a blanket on top of the block to cushion it a little bit more if that's something you need. But what we have happening is we have the adductors of the thighs are lengthening, right? So we're laterally rotating and we're abducting. So think about what's contracting is in here. We're abducting, so we have glute min, glute med, TFL, and we have slight hip flexion, just a little bit, not a lot. And again, that's going to depend on the angle of your body. And then we have piriformis and any of the, you know, the lateral rotators, glute max a little bit. So we're rolling the thighs out here. And then you have options with the arms. If you are starting to prep for a pose that is more of a chest opening, you can bring the arms out to the side. You could bring the arms to the belly. And then to come out, we bring the feet together, knees together, pardon me, and bring the feet down. You can always, you know, think about if you, like in this case, we're prepping to open up the hips. But there's a bunch of different ways you can do it. But you want to think about what's contracting. And we're also using that medial gastroc a little bit when we're bringing the soles of the feet together.